The St. Paul Addiction Treatment Facility at the center of a KARE 11 investigation is accused in a civil case by the federal government of committing tens of millions of dollars in Medicaid fraud.
The owners appeared in court today for the first time, and things did get heated. Here's AJ Legault with the latest developments in our investigation, Recovery Inc.
At federal court in downtown Minneapolis, husband and wife David Backus and Sean Grigo were not happy to see KARE 11.
Get a life.
It's been just over a week since a federal raid on their business, Evergreen Recovery, that came in the wake of a series of KARE 11 reports that exposed allegations of Medicaid being billed for treatment services not provided as claimed, while the owners lived a lavish lifestyle of high-dollar cars and private jets. An affidavit by the FBI special agent in charge of the case now alleges the couple engaged in a scheme to defraud Medicaid, fraudulent billing, and illegal kickbacks. Since the raid, clients have been left largely abandoned without treatment and medication.
I'm literally living out of my car.
Back to court today, after we asked the owners what they had to say to the hundreds of clients and employees they let down.
You're a client. You know, after this, me and you are do it later, okay?
You're accused of stealing tens of millions of dollars.
And you're accused of putting 300 clients on the street because you want to stand outside.
Because
and
of your greed.
And up at us. Our greed?
Millions of dollars?
We didn't steal millions of dollars, bro. Read the state statute. Have a good f***ing life.
Everything you've said is false. Everything you said is slander. And we'll be availed at a court, I promise you that.
In court, more of the same. Backus berated the assistant U.S. attorney handling the case and claimed everything in the FBI affidavit is a lie to make them look like monsters. The judge ordered their assets remain frozen and appointed a local attorney to be receiver, basically someone with the power to make financial decisions as the company winds down. We learned the Minnesota Department of Labor received 100 complaints by former Evergreen employees accusing the owners of wage theft totaling $800,000. Among them, Sarah Gore, who says several paychecks bounced.
My electricity has been shut off. My rent hasn't been able to be paid.
Gore says the even bigger concern is Evergreen's hundreds of cast-off clients.
They're out there wandering the streets and not having places to go, and they're scared.
In court today, we learned the criminal side of this investigation, which could result in indictments, is still ongoing. At federal court today, I'm AJ Legault, KARE 11 News.